Landing a rocket on a far-off planet and implanting a medical device in a human heart are not so different. You have to be 100% certain the technology is going to work before you launch it. That's why British Heart Foundation researchers have teamed up with space engineers to build a new device to help damaged hearts. Heart failure can happen if the heart muscle is damaged, for example, by a heart attack. It means the heart can't pump blood around the body as well as it should, and patients often feel breathless and exhausted. Some people need a mechanical heart pump called a left ventricular assist device, or LVAD, to keep them alive. The first LVAD was implanted in a patient in 1963. As the technology has evolved, LVADs have become smaller and more portable than earlier models. Surgery, however, still carries risks, and being attached to batteries, which need charging frequently, can make everyday tasks difficult for patients like Jim.
Transplant wasn't achievable, and my only option was to have something called an LVAD. It's basically a heart pump which is attached to the left of the heart. It means I run on batteries by day and I almost plug myself into the mains at night. On the batteries, they last for about 8 to 10 hours.
An estimated 920,000 people in the UK have heart failure, but only a few hundred each year receive an LVAD or a heart transplant. With BHF funding, a team of cardiologists and space engineers are testing a new kind of LVAD that sits on the outside of the heart, reducing the risk of infection and blood clots. Using cutting-edge space-age technology, they're developing a smaller, less invasive device that doesn't require major surgery to be fitted. This means it could be used to help many more patients, not just those with the most severe symptoms. The work is being led by Dr. David Adlam at the University of Leicester, in collaboration with engineers from the Space Research Centre in Leicester. Their device is inserted in through the chest and uses a disc-shaped balloon to compress the heart from the outside. It does this in time with the heartbeat, forcing blood to pump through the heart more powerfully. They're still refining the device and hope to test it in humans within the next 3 years. If successful, it could offer a lifeline for many more patients with heart failure, as well as people recovering from a heart attack. Help fund our life-saving research. Visit bhf.org.uk/donate.